हर्षवर्धन बोरे स्टैंडर्ड 6 डिवीजन सी माय बुक नेम इज मैजिक ऑफ द लॉस्ट टेंपल द नेक्स्ट डे जी अबाउट नानी अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग शी हैज सेड नानी वी हैव टू गो टू सरप्राइज हाउस टू हेल्प विद द बिल्डिंग preparation there is not a word to be heard get up and have a bath eat your breakfast and then leave you know when the village did not have internet my family were from sunrise to sunset to work the maximum that we could in the night hours that into the habit of getting early and sleeping early too.
Hello everyone, my name is Sudhanshu Ranjan Singh. I study in 6th standard and my school name is St. Anthony's Convent High Secondary School. My book name is Aesop's Fables. Story name is The Bear and the Beast. Once upon a time, there lived a bear in the forest. One day he was very hungry. He roamed about the forest in search of food, but for miles he cannot find any food. So he said that I will soon die of hunger. I wish I could get something, anything to eat. He groaned. Somehow the bear dragged himself through the dense forest. All of a sudden, something caught the bear's attention. He strained his eyes and found something hanging from the low branch of a tree. He went close to the tree and there it was a beehive. The hungry bear was overjoyed as he spotted his favorite food, the honey. His mouth watered. This is what I searched for, the bear chuckled. It would be very delicious. The bear looked around and to his joy, there were no bees inside the hive. Good. It seems that the bees have gone outside to work. It's the right time, he smiled. Then he stretched out of his hands to grab the honeycomb. He jumped up to reach the honeycomb, but fell a little short of it. The bear was not ready to give up. Once again, he tried to snap at the hive. At just the bear heard of buzzing of the bees behind him. He at once turned around and saw a swarm of bees approaching, like a squadron of war planes. Now the bear knew that it would be very impossible task to eat the honey. Oh no, the guards have saw me. My precious food will getting out of my hands, he grumbled. Then suddenly a wicked thought came to his mind. All right, then if I can't eat that honey, I shall not let it hang from these bees either. And he tried.
My name is Sanskriti Pramod More. I am studying in 6th standard and my school name is St. Anthony Convent Higher Secondary School. And I am reading the Magic of the Lost Temple. 30 years ago, my daughter Akshata was a little girl who loved to play hide and seek with her friends. One day, I went for a shower after keeping my 4 bangles in a small wooden box. I then went to sleep in the afternoon. Once I woke up, I finished my chores and remembered late in the evening that I had forgotten to wear my bangles. When I opened the box, I found only 2 bangles inside. Teacher, over one paragraph. Thank you.
Yes, now I'm leaving. My book name is Life is What You Make It. Before the advent, the internet of the postman computers, we wrote letters by hand, waited for the postman to deliver even those were the days. Television drama serials like programs and when the television meant just a national channel and when the video recorders, we still in looking back, I am surprised. Given who the street and Indian, my parents were then actually allowed to write letters to a boy. The fact that I was invite boys home to visit any boys in the house. Thank you.
My name is Shreya Sandeep Bhagwat. I'm studying in 6D. My roll number is 1. I am reading Cinderella, a fairy tale. There was once a widowed gentleman who had remarried a proud and bad-tempered woman. She had two daughters who were just as unpleasant as he was. They were quite unlike the man's own daughter, who was both beautiful and good. This second wife hated her stepdaughter so much that she treated her as a servant. Thank you.
My name is Pranav Indra Patil and I study in 6C. My roll number is 48 and my school name is St. Anthony Convent Higher Secondary School and my book name is Treasure Island. Square 20, Dr. Lizzie and the rest of the gentlemen have asked me to write down the whole particulars about Treasure Island. From the beginning to the end, keeping nothing back but the rings of the island, and that only because there is still treasure not yet left. It take up my pen in the year of great 70 and go back to the time when my father kept the Admiral Benbow in and the brown old seaman with the scrape cut first took up his loading under our roof. Thank you.
Dear friends and teacher, my name is Jay Prabhakar Singh. I study in Standard 6. My school name is St. Anthony Convent Higher Secondary School. My topic name is History of Novel. The 18th century has gifted English literature to internally new forms which are without any tracks in the ancient classical heritage. One of those was the periodical essay and the other was novel. Both of these forms, especially novel, caught the spirit of the 18th century as the age of the intellectual, sentimental and realistic plane and tried to instruct the readers, which would help them to a more purposeful and virtuous life since the time of it originated. A novel has been gaining popularity and growing gradually. Today, it is recognized as the most dominant literary genre. Thank you.
Hello, friends. My name is Janvi Ravi Kiran Sarnobat and I am in Standard 3, roll number 18. My topic name is Our Environment. There are many things around us. They're from our environment. They are stone and rocks and soils. There are rivers and stream and lakes. There is air. There are hills and mountains. There are jungles. There are fields and houses. There and roads and also barren lands. We are seen. Many different animals around us, different types of trees and bushes and climbers make our environment beautiful. We too are a part of this environment. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Rishi Prashant Adangle, studying in 6th Standard, Division D. My roll number is 23. Today, my topic name is The Sun. The sun, which is at the center of the solar system, is a yellow color star. Its surface temperature is around 6,000 degrees Celsius. The size of the sun is so huge that around 13 lakh planets of the size of the Earth can be easily placed within planets of the size of the Earth can be easily placed in. Due to the gravitational force of the sun, the celestial bodies in the solar system revolve around it. The diameter of the sun is approximately 1,13,92,000 kilometers. The sun rotates around its axis, and while doing so, it revolves around the center of the Milky Way, taking the solar system along with it. Thank you.
Good Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Ishita Vishwakarma. I'm studying in 6C. My school is St. Anthony Convent Higher Secondary School. The story which I'm going to read is The Merchant of Venice. Antonio was a merchant who lived in Venice, a prosperous city in Italy. In those days, that is, about 500 years ago, sea voyages were dangerous, and yet some adventurous merchants traveled across the seas. Some others spent a lot of money in selling ships to faraway countries. These ships bagged spices and other treasures from India and other countries. The merchants sold these things in Europe. They made a lot of profit in this business. Thank you.
Dear teachers and my friends, my name is Lokesh Srinivasa Mangetti. I am Standard 6, Division C, and my roll number is 43. Today, I am telling about the sword in the stone. In ancient Britain, at a time when the land was invaded by wild barbarians, the good and noble Lord Arthur fought them bravely and drove them away from his land. The people made him king of the Britain and gave him the title Pendragon, means dragon's head, King's Arthur. Pendragon ruled Britain wisely and well. The people were content, but very soon the king died. It was thought that he had been poisoned by some traitor. There were no heir to the throne of Britain. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Ashwin Koshan and I study in 60. My roll number is 24. And today my story name is In the Search of Fortune. Bernieman's father was a wealthy merchant in the Caribbean. He wanted to become richer and richer by using his money to earn more money. One day, he called his son and said, I will give you a big ship with valuable goods. Trade and gods wisely and return home with riches. Bernieman promised to follow his father's advice and left in the search of great fortune. Only a few days has passed when the Bernieman saw a ship sailing towards him. As it passed by, Bernieman heard a sound of weeping and wailing. He bodily called out the captain of the ship and asked the reason of the weeping sounds that he heard. I am talking with me people who are going to be as sold as sails that will make me very rich. It is some of those people who are crying, said the evil captain. Bernieman was deeply touched. He offered to give all his cargo in the exchange of freedom of those people. The captain saw the valuable cows and really liked it. Thank you.
My name is Ananya Santosh Utekar. I study in Standard 6C. Noni was 12 years old. A tomboy was loved all forms of physical activity, whether it was walking, climbing, jumping or hiking. She was a foodie but wasn't interested in cooking. She was not found of TV or cartoons either. Sometimes she watched Chota Bheem, but only when her parents told her to do so. She didn't like surfing the internet or playing computer games. If she couldn't be outdoors, she preferred to read. Unlike most other girls, she didn't care about the clothes she wore to the way she looked. Her father, Dr. Shaker, bought her dresses, shirts, hairbands, and girls' accessories. But Noni usually preferred wearing a t-shirt and leggings. Thank you.